Hello students, how are you? I hope you are fine at your home. Today I am again back with the second numerical on the Kirchhoff's law. That is quite important according to the numerical part of this topic. Now, as you have seen in the diagram, there is a resistance voltage source, 3 voltage source. This is 2 ohm resistance, 3 ohm resistance, 5 ohm resistance, 3 ohm resistance. Now again, the step 1 that you know very well how to solve is, name the nodes. Now what are the nodes? Where two or more than two circuit elements meets at a point. Okay. Now this is a node. 1, 2, 3. Three circuit elements are meeting. 1, 2, 3. B, C, 1, 2. D, E, 1, 2, 3. Okay. So I have named the nodes. And A, B, C, D, E. Okay, now step 2. Okay, find the junctions. Now, what is a junction? Junction is a point where more than three or more than three circuit elements meet at a point. Now, 3 here. B is a junction. E is a junction. 3 circuit elements meeting at a point. A is a junction. And C is a junction. Now, how many junctions are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 junctions are there. Now, step 3. Okay, satisfy Kirchhoff's current law at each junction. It means we have to satisfy Kirchhoff's current law at each junction. Now, first of all, there is a junction B, A, C, E. Now, here A. Let us suppose the current, here the current is I1 and here the current going is I2. Now what is the current here? I1 minus I2. Now incoming is I1, outgoing is I1 minus I2 plus I2. Again I1. Now it is satisfied. Now here let us suppose it is I3 going. Now what is going here? I1 minus I2 minus I3. And from here it is coming I2. If you add, you will get I1 minus I3. Okay, if you add the incoming currents, you will get outgoing current as this. That is, you can say incoming is equal to outgoing. Now, this current is coming here, I1 minus I3. Now, both are incoming current at each junction. If you add both the current, what will happen? I1 minus I3 plus I3. The answer will be I1. Here, the outgoing is I1. The I1 we have given, I1 is coming. So, step 3 is complete here. You have satisfied each and every junction. Step 4. Apply Kirchhoff's voltage law at each junction. Apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay. At each Kirchhoff's voltage law. In a closed loop. The closed loop means you can say if you start from A, you have to end from to A. Okay. Now first loop I am taking A B E A. Now this is the loop I am taking anti-clockwise direction. Clockwise direction. Now what happened in this loop? While moving in a loop from A to B, you are moving in the direction of current. If you are moving in the direction of current, okay, there is a falling potential and that is represented by current into voltage. What is the current? I1 minus I2. And what is the current resistance? 3 ohm. While moving in a loop from B to E, you are moving downward in the direction of current. Again, negative sign. 3 into. What is the resistance? 5. What is the current? I3. Okay, now while moving in loop from E to A, there is a battery. You are moving from negative to positive terminal of the battery. Now what is happening? The sign will be plus 15 is equal to 0. As you know, according to the Kirchhoff's voltage law, sum of all the voltage drop and EMF while moving in a closed loop is a 0. Now solve this loop, minus 3 I1 plus 3i2 5i3 plus 15 is equal to 0. Now solve it. 3i1 minus 3i2 plus 5i3 is equal to 15. Now this is equation number 1. Now loop 2. I am taking this loop, okay, that is B, C, E, V. While moving in a loop from B to C, you are moving in the direction of current. Again, resistance into current, current is I1 minus I2 minus I3. From C to E, there is a battery, positive to negative, there is a negative sign then. E to B, you are moving opposite to the direction of current. If you are moving opposite to the direction of current, we will take positive sign of the potential, that is 5 into I3. Okay, now solve it. 3I1, I2, 3I3, 5I3 is equal to 10, minus 3I1, 3I2, 3 and 5, 8, I3 is equal to 10. Okay, this is equation number 2. Now take loop 3. Number of loop is equal to number of variable. Mind it. I am writing here. That is, the number of loop is equal to number of variable. Now you are watching. I have taken first loop, second loop and third loop. Okay. Now in third loop, what is happening? This is a third loop, closed loop. I am taking A, D, C, B, A. Now by moving in the loop from A to D, there is a current I2 and the resistance 2. You are moving in the direction of current, minus 2, I2. From D to C, there is a battery. You will take negative sign, minus 5. C to B, you are moving opposite to the direction of current. What is the resistance? 3. You will take plus sign. And what is the current? I1 minus I2 minus I3. B to A, you are again moving opposite to the direction of current. That is 3. I1 minus I2 is equal to 0. Now solve this equation. Minus 2I2 minus 5. 3I1 minus 3i2, 3i3, 3i1, minus 3i2. Now what is i1? It will be 6i1, i2, minus 2i2, minus 3i2, minus 3, minus 3, minus 3, minus 6, minus 2, minus 8i2, i3, 3i3, that's it, minus 3i3. And take minus 5 on the right side, that is 5. Now this is equation number 3. Now you are having 3 equations and you have to solve the 3 equation. Okay, now we will solve these 3 equation, okay, using matrix method. If there are 3 variable, this is 3i1, 3i2, 5i3 is equal to 15. Okay, first equation, minus 3i1 plus 3i2 plus 8i3 is equal to 10. 6i1 minus 8i2 minus 3i3 is equal to 5. Equation number 3. Now here are 3 equations. Okay, so you can write in this form, Ax is equal to b. Okay, now what is happening is, or you can say find delta. Ax is equal to b, or delta, that is the coefficient. That is 3, minus 3, 5, minus 3, 3, 8, 6, minus 8, minus 3. Now find the determinant. These are the coefficient of left side. Find delta. Now what is delta? If you are taking determinant, 3 into first row, take first row. इसको छोड़िए दिस माइनस 9 प्लस 64 माइनस माइनस प्लस 3 इंटू 9 माइनस 48, 5 इंटू 24 माइनस 18, नो सॉल्व इट, 64 माइनस 9 इट विल बी 55, माइनस 48 माइनस 39, 5 इंटू 6, 55 थ्री जा 165, 39 3. Now this is the determinant we have find out delta. So similarly we will find delta 1. Delta 1 we can replace the first column with the right side. Okay. That is 15, 10, 5. Work is two column same rahenge. Minus 3, 5, 3, 8, minus 8, minus 3. Now we will find. Hence we will find out delta 1, that is a determinant, 410 is answer. Okay. Now similarly, delta 2 you have to find. You have to replace the second column by the right side. That is 3, minus 3, 6, 15, 10, 5, 5, 8, minus 3. Similarly, you will find delta 3. Replace third column of delta with the right side. That is 3, minus 3, 6, minus 3, 3, minus 8, right side, 15, 10, 5, you will find delta 2, delta 3, now what is I1, that is delta 1 by delta, what is I2, delta 2 by delta, what is I3, delta 3 by delta. As we have find out the delta 2, that is 0, and delta 3, 150. Now we know the formula of the variables I1, I2, I3, that is delta 1 by delta. Delta 1 is, your delta 1 is 410, that is 410 by 88, delta. Delta 2 is delta 2 by delta, now delta 2 is 0. Okay, you can see this 0 divided by delta. Delta 3 is 150, we have find out here, that is delta 3. Okay, you can mark them in a bracket. This is delta 1 and this is delta 2 is equal to 0. Okay. After that we will get the value of I1, I2, I3. Thank you so much. Stay tuned. We'll meet you soon and with the new numerical. Thank you.